Hamlet, North Carolina, the theoretical intersection point of four separate subdivisions that all meet right here on this diamond. Looking to the north on the Hamlet Terminal subdivision towards Hamlet Yard and Marston, and looking towards the south on the Hamlet subdivision, which starts just a mile from here at South Hamlet. Now looking west onto the Wilmington subdivision, which begins again less than a mile from here at S254.1. While the diamond is certainly one of the main reasons for our visit, it's worth noting this historic piece of architecture. Hamlet Station, a Queen Anne-style station originally built as the Seaboard Airlines passenger station and a division headquarters in 1900. This station would later be added to the National Register for Historic Places in 1971. The station would also be rebuilt in 2002 as a part of a restoration project which included moving the station across the tracks to where it stands today as a museum. It's early on what would be a beautiful Sunday in the Hamlet area, and as the sun crests on the horizon, passengers awaiting the arrival of Amtrak's Silver Star patiently wait as the horn of the approaching train can be heard in the distance. With a pair of P-42 DCs as power, today's Silver Star pulls into the station on just one of the many stops on his journey to New York Penn Station. After pulling into the station and setting the brakes, the engineer aboard PO-92 climbs off and the replacement hops on. This is common practice with Amtrak's long-distance trains. One crew can only take a train but so far. With the crew swap complete, PO-92 glides out of Hamlet as their cars pound the diamond on their way out of town. After about an hour or two wait in Hamlet, finally action started to pick back up, as in the distance the roaring of locomotives can be heard climbing the grade as a loaded coal train pulls up to the signal at Hamlet where they will change crews. This specific train, running as E904, a Penny Royal South Carolina to Evansville, Indiana loaded coal train, is running with three big GE locomotives, two being up front and one being around mid-train, acting as the distributed power on today's train. With the crew change complete, now it's time to get down to business. The new crew aboard E904 gets their train up to track speed as they cross the diamond heading for the Wilmington subdivision. E904 would eventually meet 2038 at Jacksonville, Florida to Charlotte, North Carolina in a motor train.
Thank you.
In the meantime, we took some time to admire some of the artifacts around the station, including the Seaboard Airline SDP-35, one of just 35 built. It now sits here as a reminder of what came before the days of the modern Tier 4 GE locomotives. SAL 1114 would receive a fresh coat of paint in 2013 after years of wear and tear from the elements that began to fade the paint. 1114 is now owned by the National Railroad Museum and Hall of Fame, which is located just adjacent to the Hamlet train station, and is open to visitors Wednesday to Saturday. It is now just after 10 a.m., and the distant rumble of GEs can be heard in the distance. QY-38 finally makes their appearance as they make their way westbound towards Charlotte with a pair of GEs as power.
Thank you. It's just after 1 p.m. now, and F-709 has finished their work in Hamlet Yard and starts off on their journey back to Wilmington. We set up at the east end of the diamond for this one to catch the train crossing this old seaboard bridge that crosses Highway 38 on the East Main Street intersection. The engraved bridge makes for a really nice shot in this mild summer afternoon. Checking the signals, the dispatcher came over the radio mentioning a grain train that would be going through within the hour while talking to a maintainer. We decided to stay, and sure enough, just after 3 p.m. Eastern Time, westbound Russell, Kentucky to Aberdeen, North Carolina, loaded grain train G46322 mounted their way off the Wilmington side. This train would eventually be bound for Candor, North Carolina on the Aberdeen, Carolina, and Western.
Thank you.
As our tenure in Hamlet comes to a close after a full day of train watching in the books, this marks yet another spot off our hit list, but we will be returning in the near future. Stay tuned for our next video with the full chase of G463 once they reach Aberdeen.